कंट्रोल योर एक्साइटमेंट टिल द एंड एंड देन पुट द क्वेश्चंस प्लीज, बिकॉज अल्टीमेटली व्हाट हैपेंस इज द प्रेजेंटर आल्सो स्टार्ट्स रीडिंग द क्वेश्चंस एंड देन द होल लिंक गेट्स ब्रोकन. थैंक यू.
दीपा जस्ट कनेक्टेड ऑन.
ओके थैंक यू.
यू कैन हियर मी नो नाउ?
या
मंजू जी, योर बिंदी इज वेरी वेरी आर्टी एंड प्रिटी.
ओह माय गॉड, माय स्पेक्स आर नॉट वर्किंग प्रॉपरली.
वेरी आर्टी एंड प्रिटी बिंदी शी इज गॉट.
ओह मंजू जी, समबडी इज कॉम्प्लीमेंटिंग यू ऑन योर बिंदी एंड हियर कम श्यामा जी.
ओह थैंक यू सो मच.
हेलो.
Hi. Aaj to abhi to your sessions working.
I was just
in the morning you had that glitch happening, na?
Yeah. It was on my iPad only.
Yeah.
Am I on the screen now?
Yes, ma'am.
Yes, you are.
But you, it was a damn good session, na? It was a very good session in the morning.
I was little disappointed. Mujhe laga main bahut hi general baat kar rahi thi. अच्छा, कैन यू सी माई ट्रे?
नो,
ट्रे दिख रहा है क्या?
नो.
हाँ, तो ये फिर वही हो गया ना, ये नीचे जो सबके वो आ जाते हैं वीडियो, सो देन आई हैव अ प्रॉब्लम बेटा. फिर खड़े हो
अब दिख रही है, इस लेवल पे दिख रही है हमको तेरे पीछे.
पकड़ के ही रखो, उधर कोई बैठ जा, वो ले आओ कुर्सी ले लो पीछे को. आप ठीक है ना?
हाँ जी, आप देख रहे हैं.
यस.
मंजू, यू इंट्रोड्यूस एंड देन वी विल रिक्वेस्ट एवरीबॉडी टू स्विच ऑफ देयर वीडियोस, अदरवाइज द बैंडविड्थ गेट्स अफेक्टेड फॉर हर ट्रांसमिशन फ्रॉम देयर.
ओके, वेलकम श्यामा जी, एंड थैंक यू फॉर अग्रीइंग टू हैव दिस फर्स्ट मीटिंग ऑफ बॉन्साई फॉर अस, एंड दैट आल्सो with such an unusual topic which we haven't heard about. So all of us are more than fascinated, you know, especially because it's you who's going to give us the demo. So aaj tak aapko aur fields mein
suna. Oh no.
But we haven't ever heard you for bonsai. So it's a privilege today to have you telling us, giving us a demo of such an unusual style. And okay. I'm sure all of us are going to learn. And I think we are now 62 members in our club, Bonsai Club. And I hope this will be the beginning of many, many more sessions that we are going to have with you now.
Oh, so, thank you so much.
You have so many credits to your name that I cannot start naming them. But
no,
I
know no.
All round, I think it would be befitting enough to describe you. You've been the president of the Bonsai Association also. So
yes.
Welcome to Bonsai Club Noida, Shyama ji, and without further delay, we'll start the session. Thank you so much,
Manju, for such an introduction. But I hope main khari utrungi is pe. And today's topic is Psyche, Saikei. It's actually Japanese landscape. And it is different from what you see nowadays as painting, and also as the Vietnamese Hon Bo No. Hon Bo No is the kind of landscape you see, which is typically Vietnamese, because Vietnam has a lot of little islands and lot of mountainous areas and everything. So considering that, they have created a kind of landscape which is very typically Vietnamese. That a problem with not problem the difference between that and the Japanese. The Japanese culture is very symbolic. It is very, should I say, Manjuji, is it okay if I speak partly English, partly Hindi?
Absolutely fine. Yes.
Hindi zaruri hai na?
Haan, bilkul.
मातृभाषा के अलावा मैं यूपी पहुंच गई हूँ तो भैया हिंदी तो बोलना ही पड़ेगा. अच्छा, तो साइके इसी के जापानीज सेंसिबिलिटीज, जापानीज सेंसिबिलिटीज आर सो डेलिकेट, दे आर वेरी डेलिकेट एंड दे बिलीव इन सिंबोलिज्म actually in you see Chinese landscape, or you see even the Vietnamese landscape, they will have little boats, they will have figurines, they will have actually they can even show a waterfall flowing down and show it in actual reality terms. But in Japanese, everything is very, very symbolic. So here, what is happening is we are only using natural things, natural items like rocks, like soil, like trees, and all their little accessories of plant material only. When you talk of psyche, you are talking of a living landscape. And it's like a painting. You're making this painting yourself. You're creating this painting yourself. So therefore, it's like a dramatic representation. It's not just ki it is a landscape, but you're dramatizing it a little bit. So you will see that this kind of a landscape will appeal very fast. It's like instant gratification. That's why it's very good for beginners also, because this is something that even beginners can use and they can make, and they can make it fast. My only objection to the landscapes and the trail landscapes that I see in our various flower shows, etc., is that we use too many artificial means, and you do not need to do that. You can, it's a painting. See, painting of M.F. Hussain is totally different from that of a Tanjore painting. Tanjore painting, you are making it with knowing very well it's going to be glitzy, it's going to be a blitz of gold and color and stones and everything. So if you look at it that way, then Japanese landscape is like a proper painting, though it's a dramatized version of it. Now, if for a psyche, you need a tray, a low tray. You can see iska depth bahut zyada nahi hai, balki chauda hai, and you need to have some edges are also very low. The edges are not very deep. Then you have to have rocks. Placement of rocks is very important, and it is the first thing you place. That's why I've already placed my rocks, because doing all that takes a lot of time. Your whole landscape is actually dictated by the formation and by the direction of your rocks. So it's very important you fix them and have them all ready beforehand. Then you have, of course, the plants. Again, the plants, we will talk as I'll bring out and I'll show you the plants. If they are smaller plants and they have smaller leaves, then nothing like it. Other thing about plants in psyche is that it is not a perfect bonsai. We are not putting bonsais here. You can, you know, train your plant, no doubt, like this one. It's trained. I have wired it and I've done everything to it. But it doesn't mean that it doesn't have its imperfection. This is not a bonsai as yet. It is a pre-bonsai state, it isn't. So we can use plants in this condition. So they can be imperfect. They don't have to be perfect. But yeah, if people are meticulous, then they will actually do this kind of work. And it always adds to the beauty of your landscape if you, you know, use something which is already semi-trained and kept. So that is a very good idea also. However, other small plants like, you know, this kind of small syngoniums, then your chlorophytums, we can add all these. These can be the small items that we'll get. So it's a little different from a group planting. Group planting is when you are putting plants of the same kind, same species. And the placement is such that the whole composition takes an shape. So there has to be an asymmetrical triangle in a group plantation. While all that is not required when you are doing a psyche. That's why I took it up, because I said it is something which will appeal to beginners also, and also for those who have already learned bonsai, even for them it will be an interesting thing to do. Now, just a little bit I'll give you about the history. It was started by Toshio Kawamoto. Toshio Kawamoto, his father had a nursery and he used to do bonsais. He used to only make bonsais in that in his nursery. Now, in World War II, all the nurseries, etc., they all got broken. Their nurseries were destroyed. The plants were destroyed. So what happened? He inherited that nursery and now he had to take care of it. So what Toshio did was that he picked up whatever the remnants of whatever was left over, some young ones, some not so good ones, and then he started putting them in trays, because first of all he did not have enough labor. You know, making a bonsai is not only labor intensive, it is also time consuming. A perfect bonsai to be made takes a long time, and also you have to be very meticulous and you have to really sit and do it very. So it takes time and it's also labor intensive, because you need labor to pick up your things, put them, everything. So he didn't have all that. It was post-World War. So post-World War, things were in a very dismal condition, the whole country. So therefore, he started putting these plants together and in large containers so that he didn't have to handle too many pots also. So he put them in a container so that these plants could get enough soil. They got more soil also, and at the same time, being Japanese, he cannot do anything slipshod. So he started making little landscapes and putting them there. Now, when they started growing and they started becoming good, material, then and they sort of overgrew the landscape also. ये भी होता है ना, landscape में बड़ा हो जाता है तो फिर proportion फिर से गड़बड़ हो जाती है. So, बड़ों वालों को निकाल के उनको फिर से बॉन्साई पॉट में डाल के उसको बॉन्साई की तरह ट्रीट किया और फिर लाके एक और किसी और को यहाँ रख दिया. सो दिस इज एक्चुअली बिकम्स लाइक अ ट्रेनिंग ग्राउंड फॉर मेकिंग परफेक्ट बॉन्साई. नाउ दैट्स हाउ ही स्टार्टेड एंड देन ही फॉर्मड अ साइके एसोसिएशन ऑल्सो. आफ्टर दैट ही वेंट इनटू साइके इन अ बिग वे एंड ही स्टार्टेड सेलिंग दीज ओनली, बिकॉज पीपल वर people who had kind of lost their morale and everything, they were, like all depressed, and after all this problem of World War II, so for them seeing creation all over again, because after destruction they were so depressed with it all, so when they were seeing creations of this kind, it uplifted them. And once it uplifted them, then they started purchasing these and keeping these at home instead of bonsai. So saike is a Japanese landscape, and there are a few rules in saike, like how the land is laid. Now that is not so important in a bonsai. In a bonsai, the tree is important. The land itself is, the soil itself is only a means to hold that plant. And we do a little bit of landscaping, etc. But still, that is not the important part of a bonsai. Bonsai is to be, the tree is perfect. Here, the soil, the layout of the soil is very, very important. How we lay it out, how we make it into a landscape. So now, what is of great importance, as I just told you, is that you have to have these stones laid out first, and then you can replace the whole design. Has to be more like a multiple planting. The design of your landscape is that of a multiple planting. That by multiple, I mean that you don't have to stick to one species. You can have multiple species of things like that. But here you have to remember one thing. The moment you make multiple species, please stick to the habitat. That means, mountainous landscape, if you're doing a mountainous landscape, then all the plants should subscribe to a mountainous area region only. ये नहीं कि mountainous plants के साथ आपने succulents भी mix कर दिया या कुछ sea coast की mix कर दी, tropical or temperate plants mix कर दिए. No, habitat is very important because later you will be watering this plant like any landscape, any tree garden. You have to see that the watering requirement is the same, the requirement of sun is the same, so that feeding pattern also is the same. Then only everything will live together in a container like this homogeneously. So here once again you have to see that the structure of the landscape, may you have a lot more freedom. In a bonsai, rules are very strict. Okay, how you place it, where do you put your plant, you put it on 1/3, 2/3 position, and it has to be like this. Long branch should be on the empty side of the container and short branch on the smaller side of the container. All those things, the position in the pot, the style in the pot, all that makes a lot of difference. Besides, the pot itself has to be in harmony with your bonsai. No such thing in a psyche. In a psyche, you are given a lot more freedom of expression, and you can show seasonality also. You can show to a large extent, you can show a lot more things in it. Now in bonsai, we always talk of austerity. When we are showing a bonsai, we show simplicity and austerity in the bonsai, in the shape of the bonsai, in even in your layout of the branches and everything. But here you have no such rule or regulation. Here you are doing a totally aesthetic response is required, and no rigid schooling in bonsai. I thought that is why I chose this subject, because it is so different from the rigid school of bonsai. From where now people are breaking out, but still, until you don't know the rules, you cannot break them, and you can't create a harmonious. So this is how you will, now I will create it, and then later we will talk about how to make. Now I'm going to take it to the front.
थोड़ा और नीचे.
हाँ
हाँ
Shyamaji, can you ask him to come little closer so that the plants are little... Thank you.
Now, can you see the tray?
No,
tray chup gaya. No, this is fine in the sense that he doesn't have to show my face. You can see the plants. Okay. Now I'm taking the plant I'm using. अच्छा थोड़ा ऊपर कर दो, प्लांट्स भी दिखने हैं ना, तो पीछे हो जाए थोड़ा सा पीछे और थोड़ा.
हाँ बस परफेक्ट है,
परफेक्ट. ये कहाँ गया छोटू, उसको आना था.
प्लांट्स के नाम भी बता दीजिए.
ये प्लांट जो मैं यूज कर रही हूँ, दिस इज ब्राया, ब्लू ब्राया. And it has very beautiful flowers. Can I just take a break? Because I needed the help of my fellow.
Yes, yes, sure.
Usko bola tha aane ko, but he is, as usual, skipped.
You know, this blue baraya is available at Rakesh Tenney's nursery.
Yeah, and for other
and the
people
yellow one also.
Yellow one. Hello? Kahan ho? Nahi, nahi, aap idhar aao. Tumko bola tha na 3 baje aane ko. Jaldi aao, haath dho ke aao.
Kaam kar raha hoon.
Deepa, how many of us are there attending?
One minute, I'll just check, tell you. We are 50 today.
Okay. So Shyamaji, you sure made an entry with a bang in the Bonsai Club also.
Oh.
Hellbound, absolutely, you know. Bilkul naya topic, and so it's sounding easy, of course.
No, when I finish it, then I'll just explain to you even more in detail.
ये एज क्या होगी इन प्लांट्स की, आपने इनको कितना ट्रेन किया है श्यामा जी?
ओ, ये तो अब मेरे पास कम से कम नहीं तो 5-7 साल से हैं, एंड आई गॉट देम एज स्मॉल कटिंग्स फ्रॉम बॉम्बे. दे वर जस्ट लिटरली नॉट पेंसिल थिकनेस तो अब हो गई है. दे वर लाइक अ कटिंग, रियली लाइक अ कटिंग.
वाओ,
so I just put them in a small pot, and I have first I allowed them to grow. Now this is the secret of any bonsai. Any material you bring from anywhere, first you put it in a growing or a training pot. And once you put it in a training pot, then you allow it to grow. Please don't be in a rush to do एकदम से. जो पीपल मेरे को यही बोलते हैं कि आप पॉटिंग दिखा दो, कैसे पॉटिंग करते हैं, दैट इज नॉट इम्पॉर्टेंट. व्हाट इज इम्पॉर्टेंट इज द ट्रेनिंग ऑफ द प्लांट. पॉटिंग इज द लास्ट थिंग यू डू इन अ बॉन्साई पॉट. दैट इज द लास्ट थिंग यू हैव टू. हाँ, उसको यू हैव टू फर्स्ट ट्रेन इट.
Also, another problem is most of the nursery people now are trying to pass off Pachira as the best plant for making a bonsai.
Are, don't talk. Nursery people are always ripping us. Yeah. It is true, truthfully. 1 minute. Ye tha. The site. Ab mitti dal. This is the part where you need help, and that's why I just. Now this blue briar, the nice thing about blue briar is that you take it and you have been you keep it in a pot for 2 years, and when depends again upon the way you have been growing it. So sometimes if you are lucky, it can become a very nice and luxurious plant even a year also. After it has grown and you can see that the branches have developed what we call lignification. What is lignification? They are lignins in a plant which makes the bark hard. So when you make this, when it lignifies or the branches develop brown covering over it, then they are ready for wiring. Not before that. So you have to, wait for that to happen to your plant. So don't be in a rush to, start wiring your plant and pruning your plant. No, let it grow. The longer you let it grow, what happens is the sun, with the help of the sun, there is a lot of chlorophyll and there is photosynthesis. And the food is made by the plant. The more food it makes, the healthier the plant. If you start pruning and cutting it, you are reducing all the solar panels. If you reduce the solar panels, then what happens is that the plant, it stops. It doesn't make that kind of food. So it will never become strong. So always I keep saying, please allow your plants to grow so that they have made enough food and each branch is now nice and strong and becomes healthy. Only when it becomes healthy can you see Now, this is the structure of my landscape. I have put the smaller ones, one small one at the back to give you that perspective. And this slope that you see of the plant is going with the slope of the rock. In the same direction as the rock faces, or whichever direction the rock is going into, same direction may your tree should be. Your tree cannot go contrary to the direction of the rock. So it's very important that you have this direction corrected. Okay, now this is the structure of the plant. Okay, now I will start by adding all the little things to it. So I have a few small plants that I am adding. Now, while I'm doing it, I know it's not so interesting. So if you have any questions also, you can keep asking them while I'm doing this.
Shyamaji, they say how to decide which rocks to use and where and how to place them.
Yeah, now placement of rocks is very important. That is the picture that you are creating in your mind. The main thing is that it's a picture. The picture, how you plan to make this painting. Once you make, you decide on how you make the painting, then thereafter only can you decide ki what type of rocks you will do. Now, the rocks I've used are actually riverbed rocks. Okay, so you can see I will be at the end of it making a river. So when I'm making a river, the rocks are also belonging to that area. Now, if you are making a mountainous, or you're making even a desert kind of a landscape or anything, then you have to accordingly see to it that you take yellow rocks. If you are doing desert, then yellow rocks to blend with your yellow sand. So according then you can use your jade, you can use your jade as a tree, and you can use all succulents in your landscape. So that time it would be better if you used yellow colored rocks, because if you see in the desert, you will see a lot of yellow colored rocks, and sand is also of the same color. So therefore, just keep those things in mind when you are doing. Now,
okay, the next, sorry.
Haan, boliye, boliye.
There's a question about the soil mix. Is it clay mix? Is it clay soil or?
No. Sorry, can I just take a moment?
Because
ये हरा पोर्शन ऊपर रहेगा. आई एम नाउ एडिंग सम मॉस, ग्रीन मॉस. एंड green moss, see the soil here in this kind of a landscape, the soil has to be rich. It has to be rich because it is supporting a lot of foliage. So it's nicer to use a thicker or a heavier soil, as we call it. Otherwise, now in bonsai, we have started saying that to use a lot of drainage material like khangar ka chura, etc. in and make our bonsai soil very, very porous. We have started doing that. But isko ulta do, ab ek ek chappa leke usko laga. Ha, sorry. But in a landscape, I don't like to have that gravelly soil. First of all, your moss will not grow your moss will turn yellow, and it'll dry up and become brown very, very soon. So it's nicer to have a nice heavy soil in this kind of a thing. So what I would suggest, the soil mixture should be one part garden soil, one part compost, one part leaf mold, and one whole part of old cow dung. Old cow dung, I do not favor vermicompost so much. No, I don't favor it, because then if it is not properly strained and kept, then what happens is that you have a lot of earthworms in your pot later. And earthworms will then tend to eat into your root system and everything. So, and whatever they leave behind is also a very crusty formation. So when this crusty formation takes place, then it is not so rich for your plants. So now fine, going back to the soil mixture, therefore we have one part soil and one part cow dung manure, old cow dung, and one part compost. You can even make that two parts if you do not get good cow dung. If you do not get old cow dung, then use your compost only, and you can make it with that also.
And do you need to add any bone meal and neem khali also?
Yeah,
for this?
Yeah, I'm coming to that. Then okay. you have got this mixture now with you. And once you have this mixture, you all mix them all together nicely. And then you just add one part sand. Half a part of sand. Half a part of sand and a little bit of charcoal. I always recommend charcoal, because charcoal will absorb all your, impurities of your soil, of your, water. It absorbs all that. So you can add a little bit of charcoal to counteract all that. Mix this all together nicely. You mix it all together, and then you can add about 200 to 300 grams of neem khali for a pot of this size. And thereafter, you can put bone meal more as a top dressing. So once I've made this soil and I've laid it out on my in my pot, and when I've done this kind of arrangement and everything on it, then later I can just give bone meal ka pani. I can just give bone meal ka pani. One other thing that people have started doing nowadays is that they take an old socks and usme old gobar ki khad ko usme pack karke with a little bit of bone meal, they add, then they just place it. Many of them hang it on one of these branches so that when they water, uska pani dheere dheere jaye. So this kind of a soil is much better for your for a landscape, for a psyche. But for other bonsais, mitti depends exactly on what kind of species of plant you're going to use. Now here I come back to say that if you are using junipers in your landscape, then you cannot use the mixture that I have just told you. You cannot use that. You'll have to use something which has lot and lot and lot of gravel. And gravel becomes 50% of your mixture. So if you are doing it with junipers, then please, whatever mixture you make with compost, with soil, garden soil, and with your compost, reduce the compost. then you have to reduce your compost.
Okay, next, Shamaji, they are asking about moss, this green moss. They say, where do you get it from?
And oh, this is the best time. This is the best time to go looking for moss, because the moss that abhi barishon mein, wherever you will find, any wet area, jahan pe dhoop bhi aati ho, thodi si chutputi si dhoop, then you will find ke wahan pe, if you look for it, you will find this green moss growing on it. Now I'm going to add some bajri to give you the appearance of a river. And my bajri is not just pure white. It's a mixture of gray and black also. I wish we could have seen this live, because the effect of the moss and everything is a lot better when it is a live demonstration.
We can wait for that, Shamaji, when our actual meetings will start happening.
Yeah, yes. Yes, because hope, it springs eternal. We are all hopeful that the day will come when we can, you know, see this happening.
Yeah. Now we realize the importance of, you know, being able to of, quickly without a thought, and ab sab soch rahe
hain. Ye sab nikal rahe. So you, except for the laying out of the soil, which I had done before, you can see that it didn't take very long when I completed this thing or parsley.
Wow, it's looking gorgeous. Amazing.
Now you can see that I've used these little growing things, and then something here, and the contrast of having a river flowing in between, and these are two islands, one looking overlooking the other. So this is how it is. Thoda side ko aao, pura aur upar karo. Side ko aao.
Yeah.
Aur upar. Yun karo. Haan. Nahin, ab off ho gaya bilkul. Haan, like this, bilkul. Ab aise hi khade. Thoda idhar ko ho. Now is it better? You can see now that all three trees are there, and one is a smaller tree, and these two are the main island, and therefore these are the of course, if I had some more moss, I would have put it yahan pe thoda ye le ja isme se hata. So this is your psyche. Now the care of this psyche, how do you take care of a psyche? It's very nice. You have to put it out in the sun, because I've just planted it today. I will keep it in the shade for about a week, and thereafter I will so thereafter what I will do is I'll bring it out into the open after about a week, and slowly bring it out into the sun. Once it comes out into the sun, then it is to be kept outdoors. As you all know, bonsai is a outdoor plant, and it's not a indoor plant at all. So this has to now remain outdoors. Now comes the question of how do I maintain this moss? This moss, if you can keep this not in absolute bright sunshine, but in kind of a semi shade, because braya ke liye that's fine. Braya, let me tell you more about braya. Braya is from, again, from Vietnam. It's a plant that has been brought from Vietnam and come to Thailand and all the Southeast Asian countries. From there, it has now been brought to India, and we find that it is doing very well in India. There's no problem. problem in Delhi is the acute summer, the extreme summer. So in the summer, I put all my bonsais under a net, and green net, and the green net covers all sides, particularly the south and the west. It is open from the east, and even the north side, I normally cover it and make a gate kind of a thing from where I enter. So I cover that also so that there's no through air passing through. So it's closed from three ends, and east side is open so that little bit of the sun can come in. Anyway, the sun goes overhead in summer. So upar se aapko indirect light puri milti hai. So in those places, we don't have to worry too much because ye moss green hi rehta hai. But definitely it likes to be sprayed. This moss now is protecting your soil, and it's like a filtration for your soil. For the water ko filter kar deta hai, and it keeps all the impurities away and only filters the water and gives it to your plants. So you can, but if you spray it also twice a day, it will remain green with you. Now in monsoons, there is no problem. Whole of summer is where is a major problem. Okay, you protected it, then you have come to August, July, August. As you can see in Delhi, we do not get much rain. We get rain only in August mein jaake. To ye sab rakhte andar. To August mein, now when there is so much of excess rain, also you have to protect it, because then all this soil will get washed off and the whole level will come down, and then once again you'll see all your roots coming out. So therefore it's very important again to keep it under some kind of a shade. I continue to keep my net on till end of August. I open it jaake September mein. So when I open it, then mostly the real bad rains are over, then I open it. And you will find that this will remain green. Now comes your winter. Thank you. Now comes your winter. When you come to your winter, you'll find once again, it's too cold for this. So it can turn brown. Do not worry. If it turns brown, let it turn brown. It will come up again as soon as the weather starts warming up, it will come up again. So once again, it will slowly, as the summer comes, it turns green once again. And then it continues to remain once. In fact, it, because of that growth in summer, it's a thick, mere isme bonsai isme, it becomes a thick carpet. Balki unme se hi nikal ke maine iske liye use kiya hai. So you can see that this kind of winter is the only problematic area. It's a big problem for Braya also. Braya does not like that extreme summer. It does not like loo because it is not used to loo. So again, that's why I close my west side of my area jahan pe ye bonsais rakhti hu, taki loo cannot go through it, you know, in a harsh way. This green net cuts it through. So that is one thing. Then in winter, I put a poly covering on top of my area, and it is totally again sealed from the north side, and only little bit of the east, east also I block off. What I keep open is my south side. So southeast se aapka sara sun aata hai iske upar, and diagonal sun girta hai, so it's fine. During the night, it's totally sealed off. In my poly house, you can sit in winter and take off your sweater and sit and work on all your bonsais. Itni garmi ho jati hai uske andar. Aajkal, my malis and all have started complaining ki ji bahut zyada garmi ho jati hai aur umas bahut ho jati hai, which is very good for the plants. The plants love that umas, and they love this warmth right through winter. So I don't have a dormancy in my bonsais. Dormancy naam ki cheez nahi hoti mere bonsais mein. They keep growing through the winter. Wo dormancy in mein aati hai January mein jaake. Apne aap hi, which is a natural phenomena. So apne aap hi usme dormancy aa jati hai, wo ruk jati. Actually dormancy pata kab hoti hai? Hoti hai winter, summer mein. When June and May middle se leke June tak jo garmi hoti hai, us time pe plants do go into a kind of dormancy. What is the dormancy? Usme that अब मेरे को दे दो. The dormancy is that the plants, what are they doing with the kursi laga de? What are they doing with the water at that time? All that they are doing with water is that they are using that water for air conditioning. They are cooling themselves down in summer with the water which is given to the plants. They are not using it for making photosynthesis and making the food. No, they are absolutely dormant at that time. They, you will see in most plants, nahi patte nahi nikalte. Only in a few like jungle jalebi hai ya aapki celtis hai, inme phir bhi growth hoti. Lekin aapke ye sare braya aur ye sab koi, they are dormant and they are just resting, just using that water to cool themselves down. So the water goes up and then it transpires and excess water goes out of it. And then just like we perspire, they also perspire and let out the excess moisture. And then once again, they take up moisture again. So that is how they go into that kind of a dormancy at that time. Now, so at these, through the year, therefore, you can take care of this plant and it's not difficult to grow at all as long as you are careful. See, be sensitive about your plants. Even when you start growing your plants, na, ek saal aapke saath, jaise wo plants rehte hain, you start noticing these things. Aray, isko thand bardasht nahi hoti. Aray, isko koi problem nahi hoti. So you'll slowly get used to it. And when you start taking care of them and protecting them, if you don't have a poly house also, just collect them all together, huddle them together, jaise, आप देखते हो ना लोगों को रोड पे जो जिनके जिनको ठंड लग रही होती है वो लोग सब एक साथ इकट्ठे बैठते हैं सो दैट द बॉडी हीट्स कैन बी एक्सचेंज सो सिमिलरली द सेम थिंग हैपेंस टू प्लांट आल्सो हडल देम ऑल टुगेदर एंड देन कीप देम अंडर सम काइंड ऑफ अ प्रोटेक्शन सो दिस काइंड ऑफ प्रोटेक्शन इज वेरी गुड फॉर योर प्लांट्स
एंड yeah. Could you give us the names of a few plants which would be suitable for a psyche?
For psyche, anything with small leaves and small, you know, tree, like even your Ficus microcarpa, your chote wala Ficus that you're getting nowadays, the Ficus compacta. Ficus microcarpa is excellent for making a psyche. Now in a psyche, what I have done is, I have used three plants, but you can use one single plant also. So if you have a nice, thoda itna bada, well-shaped tree, bonsai tree, may not be perfect. Doesn't matter. We don't want perfection in this. In this, the plants are imperfect, but what is important is not the perfection of the plant, but the perfection of the scene you have created. That is what is important, not the plant itself. That is like a natural plant growing. So single plant you can use and you can make a very nice body like a little hill kind of a thing and then niche ko depression mein jaake phir wo sara pani ho sakta hai. It can be a seaside one with a coastal thing where there is a cliff and then there is a sea beyond it. So you can make that. You can do it with two trees. Always remember the bigger tree will be in front and the smaller will be at the back because that gives you perspective. Whenever you look at something in the distance, wo aapko chota dikhta hai, hai na? Aur jo aapke paas hai, wo bada dikhta hai. So that sensibilities we have to maintain. And that's how we keep the chota one at the back. So two of them also looking down into a pond. So it can be a tropical little oasis that you have encountered inside a forest where you have got a little pond niche and then thode patthar patthar laga ke aapne ek chota sa hillock jaise bana diya and these two trees on it. So anything with small leaves and small branches and you can, it's a small tree. It doesn't have to be a full big tree. Then you have to make a big psyche to justify the proportion.
Is a water body an essential feature of psyche?
Yes, yes.
Okay.
Rocks, plants, water, soil, of course. These are the essential parts of a tree landscape to be made by in the Japanese way. psyche way. You have to give some impression of water.
Okay.
It can be little, it can be, but you will not actually put water. That Japanese will never do. Like okay. We do in the Vietnamese or in the Lingnan school of China. They do that. They can actually show a little bit of water at the base and a big mountain with a tree cascading down and little boats going in that water. They can show that. It's part of their, you know, philosophy. And in the Hanban, no, also, they can show two big mountains and the river flowing in between or the sea flowing in between. But water, yes, water is an essential part.
Okay.
Japanese will show it symbolically. Like these white stones that I have shown you, that is a symbolic representation of water. It could be whatever. You know, you have to imagine. You have to imagine ki this is a river which dried. Mm-hmm. Suki river okay. Which dried. Or it's a riverbed and the monsoons haven't come as yet. So the river isn't in spate. All kinds of things. It's up to you what you imagine. See, even for the viewer, isn't it? In a painting also, we go to galleries and we see the painting. If the artist is standing there, he will give you what he thinks, what he has made it, with what idea. But if you are just watching on your own, then you will see that you imagine something and then whoever is standing next to you will say, no, I think it's this. I think it's that. So that is the symbolism in any painting. So similarly in this also, that symbolism has to be there. You have to interpret it in whatever way you like. Like I gave you so many options of this water being what it is. It can be anything, isn't it? So that's...
Can we have a little overview of the moss and the plants that you've planted?
Yeah.
Top view ek thoda sa.
I don't. When somebody else is doing it, then it's I can see it.
Yeah. So essentially, you put you've used syngoniums, and these are chlorophytums.
Yes, I had lots of chlorophytum. Ke chote chote, you can see. Bachche growing out of it. This is an umbrella plant ka chota bachcha.
Okay.
The chota wala umbrella plant, the miniature one, uska chota sa bachcha aa raha tha. So I used that.
Achha, Shyamaji, there's a question which says, what is the right time to take the pots out, the plants out of the pots and make a psyche?
Oh, this is the best time. Your monsoons are always the best time that you can use for making a psyche. But once again, February, March is also a good time normally for planting. But I won't recommend you make a psyche. Why? Because suddenly the heat catches up. Sometimes March can be very hot. Not like this year. This year we had a lovely March, which was in fact cold, if anything. But instead of that, we can, you can't say. Sometimes April touches 42. So your root system are still not strong enough to take on all the various, problems of the heat. So I prefer to use the monsoons, and that also when a nice rain has come and you're anticipating more rain, that is the time you should make a psyche, because that what happens is that you have used the moisture in the air for your root system. And after that, again, if rain falls on it, it's very good for the plant. Ekdam wo uski jade bhagne lagti hain. This is, I prefer. And don't make it too late. Let it be up to end of August, yeah, first week of September, because you need the time for the roots to settle. Up to October, they need to settle down. By November, they are withdrawing. First of all, in November, by 15th of October to 15th of November, the plant is now making its food, not for its leaves. Now it's not doing it to make its branches longer. It's now saving up all the food that it is making for its wood, for wood production. So the girth If that is the time when you feed it well, then the girth of your plants go up, because all that food is going into that wood part of it. So it's not going into root development also. So therefore, you have to be very careful that you don't extend your Psyche period into middle of September. Because by October, it will settle down. The roots will be settling down. They take about almost 4 weeks to settle down. So then after that, immediately when it starts production, it's doing it for the girth and it's not doing it for your branches. So your branches won't develop. And we need the branches to develop as soon as we plant new bonsai.
And the, any feeding schedule for this?
Yes, see, for the first 2 months, I don't think you need to feed it as such. But as I told you, if you can make a big lump of old sada hua gobar ki khad in a nice muslin cloth, wrap karke usko aap apne bonsai ke ye psyche ke upar dono mounds ke upar chota chota do mounds laga ke bandh ke usko wahan rakh do. And then as you're watering, slowly the water is seeping through. That's a very good way of doing it. And Amazon mein pehle achhe se chote chote fertilizer baskets milte the. Bade sundar se chote wale with a big spoke at the end of it. I used to put a little bit of, bone meal and neem khali in it. And it used to have a lid also. Actually, if you go to Bangkok, aajkal jana to kahi nahi hai, but if you, whenever this cools down, in Bangkok, you get these chote fertilizer basket in the Chattu Chaat market. You can fill that up with even your gobar ki khad and dig it into the soil. Ye basket upar rahega aur spoke pani, mitti ke andar chala jayega. Jab pani doge, dheere dheere seep ho jata hai into the soil. And that's how that kind of a feeding is also very, very good for your plants. And the baki liquid manure is good. Okay. And enzymes are the best. Best is your enzyme and BioVita. You feed it every 15 days. Enzyme ko har 15 din aap spray karo uske upar, to foliage ke through wo nutrition gather kar raha hai. और बायोविटा को मिट्टी में डाल दो. अगेन मेक स्मॉल सैशेस एंड पुट देम. यू नो पीपल गेट इन लंदन एटसेट्रा, दे गेट टी बैग्स, एम्प्टी टी बैग्स. सो उसके अंदर वो डाल के अपने गार्डन में पेड़ों को टांग देते हैं, पेड़ों पे टांग देते हैं. जैसे इसकी ये ब्रांच है तो आई कैन जस्ट हैंग इट ऑन दिस ब्रांच एंड व्हेन आई वाटर इट देन स्लोली स्लोली द वाटर कीप्स गोइंग एंड द न्यूट्रिशन कीप्स गोइंग. दैट्स अ वेरी गुड वे ऑफ डूइंग. प्लांट टैब्स आर ऑल्सो देयर. एनपीके के प्लांट टैब्स होते हैं, वो आप डिग कर दो सॉइल में, वो भी रूट्स को स्टेम से दूर. जो कुछ भी फीडिंग करोगे, जो भी प्लेसमेंट करोगे, स्टेम मेन ट्रंक से दूर आपने रखना है, जहां आपको पता है रूट बॉल कहाँ पे है. अच्छा, उसकी दूसरी चीज ये है, अगर आपने रूट बॉल के इस तरफ को रखा इस बारी, नेक्स्ट टाइम व्हेन यू मेक दिस, you'll make put it on the other side. So keep changing your places also. Then your all your roots will keep getting food.
Shamaji, okay. There's a question about the old cow dung. How many months old?
One year old. Therefore, you get your cow dung. Even now, you get old cow dung. I mean, you get your cow dung, jo achhi sadi hui hai. And put it in a katta and just forget about it and keep it in one corner. That will become very beneficial for you later to add to your soil, etc.
When is the repotting required in this, Shamaji?
Now I will say repotting is only when one of the trees goes out of control and becomes a bigger tree. So then you will remove that. As such, you do not do repotting in a landscape. But it keeps changing. So some plants will become smaller, some might die, some might something. So when you are removing it and you put a fresh plant in it, before that, you can sprinkle some fresh soil onto it and make the landscape again. A little bit, not the whole thing. These are all temporary. You will not have a psyche which lasts you for 200 years and all that. No. As I told you, the purpose of psyche...
Like a terrarium, yeah. Which keep changing as the plant then grows.
Yes, okay. Yes. That's right.
Shamaji, आपने इतना सिंपली बताया है. आई नो इट्स अ टोटली न्यू टॉपिक फॉर अस, बट यू मेड इट साउंड सो सिंपल एंड हमको लग रहा है हम अभी बना लेंगे जाके.
Yeah, you can. My only request is that इस टाइम पे आप जल्दी से कोई प्लांट्स को तैयार कर लो and start wiring them and you know do that all. Yeah. And next season mein you make a psyche. So you are prepared with your plants. So देखते ही आपका प्लांट आपका साइकिल सुंदर लगेगा.
Okay. Any more questions, Deepa?
I don't see any more.
Have I finished very soon? Because I was so worried I'll be late.
No, you've done.
So if they want to ask any questions related to bonsai as such, any other questions also?
Yeah.
Let me ask
Shyamaji, the thing is that one another day we saw a session where they said that the best plant should be Celtis. Now
for
developing a bonsai, is
that no. Celtis is very difficult. Why it's difficult, I'll tell you, because it grows vigorously. Now, a newcomer cannot control the growth of a Celtis. And therefore, what happens is that it loses shape immediately. Also, Celtis is very temperamental. Kab mar jaye, kab sook jaye, you cannot say. So, I don't ever recommend Celtis for a beginner. I will always depend on ficuses or maximum bougainvilleas for beginners to use.
Okay, that's one query answered. Now, Krishnaji, blue briar is available at the Greenery Nursery in Indirapuram, which is nearest to us, or you have to go to Chhatarpur to the
Greenways.
The Greenways Nursery, which is very far.
Yeah.
Yeah. And इसी stream में श्यामा जी कुछ थोड़े से और ficus microcarpa apparently is the easiest one to begin with.
Yes, absolutely. That is the best. It's a hardy plant. You will get chote ones also. Manoj's nursery has lots of small. Shomik Das has lots of microcarpas also. And he has wax malpighia also. Wax malpighia is also very good for making this kind of bonsai. Because chote ones, you can take small ones, train them quickly and make a small psyche and you can keep it in your house. This is so nice to just bring it inside the house whenever you have a party and you can, you know, show it. It looks very pretty.
And this is really good for us because both of them have shifted to Noida now.
Yeah. Yes, Noida, they are now
striking it lucky.
Yeah, so you are lucky because for us, we can't come out at all right now. And to go to Noida is a very big challenge for us.
That's true.
They are very nice.
How any to more questions? The trunk? Thickening of trunk, kaise karein?
Now, thickening of trunk, there are two ways. One is if you allow the apex to keep growing, then you will find that your trunk becomes thicker because the energy is flowing through it and very fast is growing. But better than that, I find is leaving a branch lower down in the near the trunk, which is on the trunk, but lower, the one-third position se main niche aa jaye kahin pe. Allow that to grow and just let it grow. When it grows, the trunk also becomes thicker. Phir, one fine day when you find your trunk is thick enough, then you cut it from the sides. Third way. Again, which I do even for my big bonsais, is that I take that plant and put it in a pot. So I put that pot into another pot. So I do double potting. And the double potting mein kya hota hai ki niche wale pot mein achcha nutritious matti bharo. Khub badhiya sa gobar ki khad, compost, sab karke. एंड ये आपके जो पॉट में से जब रूट्स नीचे चली जाएंगी तो एकदम से ग्रोथ होने लगता है प्लांट में. तो एवरी सिक्स मंथ्स पिक अप दिस पॉट ऑफ योर्स, कट दोस रूट्स नीचे से, पुट इट बैक इनटू दैट सॉइल. तो आपकी ग्रोथ जो गर्थ मोटी हो गई है वो तो कहीं नहीं जाएगी. ब्रांचेस भी आपके कुछ नहीं होगा, आप प्रूनिंग करते रहिएगा तो जितनी आपकी फोलियज ऊपर है वो आपको इसकी रूट सिस्टम सपोर्ट करेगी, उसको कुछ नहीं होगा. दिस इज बाय फार द बेस्ट मेथड, डबल पॉटिंग एज वी कॉल इट. एंड
बहुत ही अच्छी टिप, आई नेवर हर्ड ऑफ दिस.
दिस इज व्हाट वी ऑल आर डूइंग, दिस इज व्हाट एवरीबॉडी इन दिल्ली इज डूइंग, डबल पॉटिंग. And I can tell you, with double potting, within a year, the gourd size kind of goes from 1 to 1.5 to almost 2, especially your ficus.
Oh, that's
best method. Nice. And even the if you want a branch, if you want a branch to thicken, now it's your lowermost branch, and it is thinner than your compensatory branch.
Yeah.
So if it is thinner, इसको thicken करना है ना, why lose out on it? I don't want to cut it. So I allow it to grow. And the मोटा वाला जो साथ में जो compensatory branch है, जो इससे मोटा है, उसको मैं काटती रहती हूँ ताकि उसकी growth stunted रहे और ये pick up कर ले उससे. So this branch then becomes nice and thick. Once the sizes match, then I start pruning it back and taking all the other side branches to it, so that it gets not only the primary branch hoga wo, uske saath secondary branches aa gayi. Secondary branches ke alag unke apne branches jab aayenge to wo tertiary branches kehlate hain. So then your bonsai is in a process of becoming complete only when you have tertiary branches, which takes a long time to happen. Secondary branches aa jaati hain, but secondary ke phir jab bacche hone uske branches aane वो आपको थोड़ा टाइम लगता है. सो दिस इज इट. नेक्स्ट टाइम आई कैन टॉक टू यू अबाउट ओनली वायरिंग, व्हाट इज स्ट्रक्चरल वायरिंग, व्हाट इज डिटेल्ड वायरिंग, वी कैन टॉक अबाउट दैट, बिकॉज देन दैट विल हेल्प यू टू यू नो वायर योर प्लांट. एंड वायरिंग इज आवर मेन टेक्निक बाय विच वी यू नो ग्रो आवर बॉन्साइज. इट्स ओनली थ्रू दैट दैट द शेप कम्स टू अ प्लांट.
जूनिपर
वगैरह में स्पेशली जब वो वायर की मार्क्स आती है ना, तो वो स्पाइरल लुक आती है, तो वो कुछ उसके ऊपर फिर आपका टिश्यू फॉर्म हो जाता है, बट इट गिव्स अ काइंड ऑफ एन एज्ड लुक टू योर प्लांट. दैट आल्सो
स्मूथ ट्रंक होती है, डजंट इट गिव अ ग्रोटेस्क काइंड ऑफ अ लुक?
नो, इट शुडंट गिव अ ग्रोटेस्क लुक. भद्दा लुक नहीं देना चाहिए. ब्रांचेस में कभी कभी गड़ जाते हैं. कभी कभी क्या हो जाता है, आपकी गड़ गई और उसके ऊपर टिश्यू फॉर्म हो गई, so that gives a very knotted look to your trunk again, which gives a look of age. So it can be, you know, it is used as a means to make it look old. That also can be used. So wiring again is very important.
Shama ji, bahut hi eye opener and really nice. And any more questions, friends?
Nope, they all
Is Vivek ji there to take a screenshot for all of us?
No, Manju, Vivek, I don't think can do it. He's out of town.
Sure, I can do that. I can take the screenshot.
Okay.
Shama ji, aapka creation bhi.
You want me to stand behind it?
I think that would be great.
Yeah, you want to just see, because now I'm alone, so I will.
You can sit.
We've taken a close-up of Shyamaji's. Jyoti's taken that, okay. So we'll use that. We'll just take Shyamaji now.
कहाँ गए Shyamaji?
हाँ, मैं तो इसके पीछे हूँ. This is the creation. So have you taken a snapshot of it?
Vivek, just take that, please.
Yeah.
Ab Shama ji ka.
And then I will just, oh, did he do it? I don't know.
Now you have to come straight.
Yeah, can you do it?
Keep it again?
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
आप तो दिख ही नहीं रहे श्यामा जी.
अरे वो अपना
फिर पहले आप इसका लेख लो.
या थैंक यू.
एंड नाउ आई विल काइंड ऑफ
इट्स समवेयर बिहाइंड इट.
हां बिंग पुटिंग इट. लेट मी जस्ट पुट अ स्टेशन इट.
सो ट्रू नूतन जी.
हां कॉम्प्लीमेंट टू यू श्यामा जी. नूतन बोल रही है every time yeah. you take a class it is so well explained that we have no questions to ask.
Are I thought maybe ye a picture is there clear na.
Yeah
you can see the creation.
Yes sir.
Yeah
then you can have me here.
This is picture perfect.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Thank you ji.
Thank you Shama ji.
Thank you.
See you all next week on 30th for the winter bulb session now. Bye.
Okay. Thank you so much.
Bye-bye.
Bye-bye.